If we have a Monte Carlo algorithm that produces the best possible solution with probability 1/2, and we run it a couple of times, then what happens? If we run it the first time, we can be 50% sure that we already have the best possible answer. Then we run it again. So the probability in the second run is again 1/2 that we do not get the best possible answer. And in the third run, it's again 1/2, and so on. Now this is the probability of getting a suboptimal solution. And of course, if we want to be 99.9% sure that we get the best possible solution, the probability of getting a suboptimal solution should be smaller than 0.1%. And then the problem becomes 1/2 over n, and n is the number of times that we run this algorithm here, should be smaller than 0.001, which is the same as 0.1%. And then you can just solve for n and get the answer. And we have to run this algorithm just 10 times, which is pretty neat. Now, of course, for an NP-complete problem, it's very unlikely that we get a probability like this. Because, as you can see, we could very, very, very quickly in polynomial time get a solution that is almost guaranteed to be optimal. So what you will find for most Monte Carlo algorithms for challenging problems is that the probability here, first of all, becomes sometimes even exponentially small, and second, that it also depends on the input size. But we'll soon see how that works out concretely.